Okay, I'm going to go over the pros and cons of using a reverse band on the hack squat as simply as I possibly can. We know that the bottom 25-ish percent of this movement is going to elicit the most hypertrophy. So that means that the top 75% arguably isn't doing much for muscle growth. Using a reverse band is going to challenge that lower 25%, but it's also going to make the top 75% a lot harder. If I have 300 pounds on this machine without a band, it's going to be 300 pounds at the bottom and 300 pounds at the top. However, as I ascend, it's going to get easier due to the moment arm becoming short. So with the reverse band, you still want to have that 300 pounds at the very bottom, but you might have to put 400 pounds on the machine to do so because the band is helping you out in those ranges. However, instead of getting lighter as you go up, with a reverse band, it's going to get heavier as you go up. So that full degree of knee flexion, it's going to be 300 pounds. And as you ascend, it's going to climb up all the way to 400 pounds at the very top, which is going to challenge that bottom 25% a little bit more, but it's also going to challenge the top 75%. So you could argue that that's not worth it, because even though you're making the bottom 25% harder, you're also making the top 75% harder, which we know doesn't cause a whole lot of muscle gain, and it's building up a lot of fatigue. A great alternative that you can use when doing a hack squat with a reverse band is a hack squat 1.5. So on this, you go down all the way, come up halfway, go back down, and then back up for one rep. That way you can challenge that bottom 25% multiple times.